KCAA, your local connection for news, traffic weather, and sports. AM 1050, KCAA.
You're going to want to stick around because coming up next is the lovely ladies with Let's Go Shopping with Bev right here on the station that leaves no listener behind.
This is NBC News Radio.
Hello and welcome to Let's Go Shopping with Bev. This show brought to you by Starflight Entertainment. Music by Dr. Bombay and the Blue Machine Band. Song title, Living in Paradise. Now here's Bev.
Well, welcome to the show, everybody. And we are just absolutely so ecstatically happy who is going to be on this show today. So make sure that you have it tune in on the radio in the vehicle. Your home, wherever you are, get on the computer, whatever you have to do, go to friend's house, I don't care. But there is no way you're going to miss this show today. And we have three very special guests that are going to be calling in. And we all decided, us ladies, we're not going to say anything until you hear the names. But there are television programs involved. That's all I can tell you. And Christina, my liaison, how you doing?
I am doing wonderful. It's a beautiful Friday. It just started out perfect, and it's just going to end perfect. I can tell already. And I'm glad you're so excited that I'm here.
I am. Hey, Christina is one of my dearest friends, and we hang out. We get in a whole lot of trouble out there and have a good time doing it. And so I'm glad that you... Oh, you forgot your hat. Your witchy hat.
Oh, I didn't know I was supposed to wear it.
Okay.
Actually, I didn't want to mess up my water fountain hairdo today. My quick little water fountain hairdo, if you can see my little
I like it. Leave it up to her. She's a hairdresser. She knows how to do anything, you know? I mean, I absolutely love it. And
this
then
is the quick do.
The quick do. Okay, you didn't come up to my house and give my hair a quick do. And then also, bump, ba-dum, bump, bump, bump. Our second guest in that house is Elaine. Yes, Elaine is with us. And she has a program right here on KCAA 1050 AM on Thursday afternoons from 4 to 5. And it is Smart Health Talk. And boy, are we gonna talk. So how you doing?
I am so excited to be here, Bev. You are one of my favorite DJs here on KCAA.
Thank you.
And
thank you.
I tell you, in honor of you, like I said, I actually dressed for it with all my top shopping, what I call deals that I got out there, because I know that this is a shopping show, and I just wanted to show that, hey, this is like my alter ego, actually. That's why I'm thrilled to be here today. I love designing.
Uh-huh.
I actually made this dress.
Yay!
It's all
very hot. Very hot.
Yeah, and I have like some vintage Chanel earrings.
Now, where did you get those? I love those.
The American Cancer Society. It was such a find to find real Chanel vintage earrings at the American Cancer Society.
Now, did you go to one of their boutiques and find it?
Yes, one of the one over in Redlands.
In Redlands?
Yes.
Over on Barton?
Yes.
Don't you? I love that place.
Oh, I used to be there like all the time. I had to kind of like hold back a little bit because I was trying to get rid of the junk out of my life, and I said I don't get any more stuff until I finish that.
That is the coolest place. I'm glad you brought that up because I was just talking to the ladies the other day, and they're gearing up. Now, don't tell nobody.
Okay.
Okay, you promise? Christina, I know you won't tell nobody.
I'm already going there when I'm done.
they had their holiday sale already. Another one's coming, but don't tell nobody.
Oh, really?
Okay.
Oh,
yeah.
Those are the best.
Yeah.
Those are the best. I don't want to, like, well, I have this wedding dress that I'm hoping, like, someday I really can use it. But it's, like, a brand new $3,000 wedding dress that the bride never even wore.
Holy Toledo. Why? What did she wear? Blue jeans?
For it. Guess how much I paid for it there. You will never believe it. $50.
Get out of town.
At the American Cancer Society in their spring wedding sale that they have.
Oh, that was way cool how they had that set up, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. All these beautiful wedding dresses.
Well, there's another place we can add on for people to go get their Halloween costume goods.
That's right.
Hey, you could be a bloody wedding
A wedding.
Oh, they have, yeah.
Wedding
they
have bride.
You know, you
the bride of Frankenstein.
Right, the bride of Frankenstein. Around you can.
Although Elaine's way too pretty for that.
Yes.
Lots of energy. I love her energy.
You could dress up like how you said this woman never wore the dress. What, did she wear blue jeans or what happened?
Oh, yeah. It was like kind of a thing that didn't work out at the church.
Oh, okay.
And well, it actually sat in the church for like several months. No one ever even touched it. It had never been worn anything. It's the most gorgeous dress.
Now, that sounds like a good story. Afterwards, you've got to find out the whole story and let us ladies know. But you
I think
could...
you should just keep the dress and forget the party.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. And then what you could do, though, is go down there. And they're over there on Barton Road in Redlands.
Okay.
And if you're going to be taking the freeway, get off at Alabama, and you will be taking a left. Or a right. It depends on which. If you're coming in this way, you take a right. You're going this way, you
it's
take a left.
The Stater Brothers.
Right. And you go all the way up to Barton Road. The Stater Brothers is right there on the left, the big shopping center, and they're right there. And all the money that these ladies get from that store goes right back into research for cancer. Just like when Christina
Yay.
And I and 10,000 trillion people just did the Believe Walk. And all that money that was collected and donated and goes right into research.
No research, so, no research. That one, they feel a lot of money does go into research, which is needed. But that money goes directly to some of the cancer centers like, you know, well, we've discussed before, but like
uh-huh.
Michelle's Place and St. Bernardine's and Loma Linda Cancer Center. So it goes directly to like 3D imaging machines. And things like that.
So that's pretty cool. Thank you. Thank
You're welcome.
You.
Yeah, because those might be expenses that are hard for the patients to cover, and they're critical for diagnosing their disease.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I'm
that's
glad
awesome.
You brought that up. And also talking about it while we're waiting for the phone to flash. Oh, the phone is flashing. Are you ready, ladies?
Yes.
Let's all flash. It's hot in here.
Yes. Now, Eric, who is...
Yeah, because we got three hot women.
There you go.
Let's flash. Let's flash.
Eric, who is on the phone that's flashing all the pretty colors?
We have Jeff Helton from Flashback 67 Productions.
Thank you. Hi, Jeff. How are you?
Beverly, how are you?
I'm doing good. And Christina, my liaison, is with us on the board today. And also we have Elaine with us, and she does a show here on Thursday, and it is the Smart Health Talk. So you're talking to three crazy ladies. You're so lucky.
Well, you me. Good afternoon, all you ladies.
Well, hi. It's good to be talking to you right now.
Now, Jeff, would you please explain in the beginning exactly the magic that you make with the cameras that you have and how long you've been playing with them cameras?
Well, I have actually... What I have coming up right now is a medical documentary that I caught wind of a kind of a missionary team or mission team that goes to Vietnam every year, and they've been going over there for the last 15 years or so, or 13 years. And when I first heard the story about who they were and what they did, I kind of put everything that I had on hold and said to myself, you know, I want to go over there and talk to these people and see exactly a little bit more about them. And when I did that, I kind of fell in love with their whole, you know, what they're doing over there, the humanitarian aid, the, you know, the medical attention, the dental aid that they take over to Vietnam every year. And I approached the administration, Dr. Vian Doan and Dr. Branch, Dr. John Branch, both with practices right there in Riverside, and asked them, would you allow me to follow you and document everything that you guys do? This was my very first documentary. I've done nothing but, you know, short films and or, you know, getting other feature films prepared for production over the last 5 or 6 years now. And, but jumping into this, you know, full-fledged, just, you know, feeling myself, being called to go over there and do this, which is something that, you know, really spoke to me. I had always known as a child that I always wanted, you know, to be in film at a very young age. As a child, I kind of grew up on a very large farm. That experience for me has had, like, a huge impact on my writing creativity today. I mean, we had, you know, you name it, I raised it, had it as my pet, probably ate it. You know, it didn't sound too cool, but you know, it is what it is. but, you know, living on a river, living on about 40 acres, was very Huck Finn, Tom Sawyer. And, you know, I had two brothers and a sister there with me, and you know, we just had the greatest time with that. So with that, I kind of drew a lot of imagination and stories, which, you know, turned into screenplays, which turned into storytelling and later on became film. I think why I chose this documentary to follow this team over there is because my mother was a very giving, caring, nurturing person, while also being very bold and stern, raising four children while maintaining that farm. But in fact, it was after all the kids were out of the home that she went on to foster about a dozen more over the next 15 years. She just felt, you know, I know it's a lot of property to maintain by yourself, but yet on the other hand, you know, she loved children, she loved people, and I feel like I have a lot of that compassion in me to give and care for those less fortunate. And I feel like that's the primary reason that I felt it necessary to travel to Vietnam and tell the story of the Good Samaritan Medical Dental Ministry on her behalf. In fact, every film that I do is dedicated to her late legacy. But yeah, the Good Samaritan team, which I believe their acronym is the GSMDM, they're host right out of Riverside. Like I say, they're comprised of volunteers, doctors, surgeons, you know, throughout the U.S., but there's a lot of them that are right there within your vicinity. Robert Hardesty is a plastic surgeon in that area. He flies over there every year with him to perform these amazing surgeries. You've got dental people that are right there in your neck of the woods. I believe your councilman, Paul Davis, went over there this past year. He and his wife, May Davis, they both got involved. So.
And I am so glad to hear that. And I got so excited when we met you last month over in Riverside at the Crescent Jewels.
Yeah.
For the fashion show with Jesse J and Jesse J Collections. And we got talking and this and that, and that's how we all got joined. And I seen his work. It blows me away. It really does. And I am so glad that you're doing it. And now you're having the event and on Saturday, October 27th, correct?
Yes, that's Saturday, October 27th. I'm actually going to be premiering kind of a sneak preview of the documentary there at the Riverside Community Health, or Hospital Health Education Center, which is down in Magnolia there. And it's a fundraiser that the Good Samaritan organization puts on every year. It's called For the Love of a Child. And it's pretty much it's a great big dinner. There's silent auctions. One of the people that went over there with me this year, she actually, the reason that I went over there is the photographer Marcia Feinberg. And Marcia goes over there, she tries to go every year, but when she goes over there, she shoots the people with her camera, and she looks at life through a different lens than I do. But yet, on the other hand, the images that she brings back are amazing. So with my videography that I have captured, we utilize her still images in this and give it kind of a Ken Burns effect to the actual finished product. But in the end, these images that are coming out of Vietnam, the people, the health, the situation that they're in, and how humble these people are is just amazing.
It is. And what I'd like to do is next week sometime I'd like to get back into this. But also, Jeff, why we have you on the phone, the phone is flashing, and I think the next person that is calling in, you happen to know her very well, don't you?
I believe so. It's my good friend, McKee Sullivan.
Yeah, so let's find out. Don't go anywhere. Okay, Eric, who do we have next, please?
We have McKee Sullivan of America's Top Model.
Thank you.
And you know what, real quick, I Googled her picture, and you know who she looks like?
Who?
McKee. She looks like, if you remember Ferris Bueller's Day Off, when Rooney went looking for Ferris Bueller, and he goes to the pizza parlor.
Yes.
And that girl is playing the video game, and he thinks it's Ferris.